Thunderstruck. At last, we've arrived. The final episode of the year is here. And now to Julian for a special feature.
Last Friday, a series of simulated disasters was sprung upon LPS, HBS, and fire science students in an effort to test their abilities as first responders. Let's see how those students reacted in the face of disaster.
RJ, what was your experience like here at Disaster Day?
Well, we pulled a couple victims out of the structure fire and treated multiple victims. Yeah, I think this is a great chance for us to recognize the real world and what happens out there in the first responder world.
Awesome, thank you.
So I contributed today by taking care of some of the people that were on the yellow tarp, like kind of dying but not dead, and then on red, that was like people that are like about to die. I just took care of them. I was the emotional support today.
Mandy, what was it like being a trauma victim for like 30 minutes?
I was trapped under a mantle, and I had like three people ahead of me on the fire road who were all supposed to get like electrocuted as soon as like the fire hydrant and the water like touched them because there was a down power line. So getting into character really wasn't that hard. Once like the fire hydrant opened, it kind of became real because you could hear like the rushing of the water, and it was like, oh my gosh, like this is like actually happening. And I had this one firefighter, he escorted me down here to triage, and they checked like my airways, they asked me how I was doing, they asked me everything that had happened. So it was really interesting, I liked it.
Awesome, you guys did a good job, thank you.
Nice work, first responders. You've proven yourselves largely equal to the task at hand on disaster day.
As you can see, it's prom season, so here's a look at all things prom 2023.
It's a hot Monday evening, I'm suited and booted. We got the one and only Isaiah here. Isaiah, what are you wearing at prom?
So I'll just probably wear a tux, something fly.
What artists are you hoping to hear the DJ play at prom?
Oh, Yeet, of course.
I'm here with Jace. And who's your date to prom?
It's a mystery.
A mystery. All right. And who are you hoping to hear at prom? What artists?
Yeet.
Oh, another Yeet. All right.
Wow. Have you done a promposal yet?
That's a no. That's a no. I'm still waiting.
So Miguel, who would you like to take to prom this year?
I'm staring right at her.
Me?
Why?
Yes.
Oh. What are you hoping the DJ plays at prom?
I'm looking forward to maybe some Herbie Hancock, John Greaves, Cyanide Beats.
Carter, who's your prom date this year?
Me, myself, and I.
What do you think about that?
It's me. I'm his prom date.
Yeah, actually, yeah, we're going to prom together.
Aw, can you guys pose for the camera?
Yeah!
Would you, Alex Climates, like to go to prom with me?
No.
Who are you guys hoping to hear at the dance?
This man, singing loud and proud.
Yep.
What song are you gonna sing?
Playboy.
What? Say it again?
Playboy.
Well, what are your plans on prom weekend?
Prom weekend? I don't know. Maybe just ride around, have fun, hang out with friends.
That sounds awesome. Thank you, my very formal sir.
Thank you.
Awesome. See you all at the House of Blues in Anaheim on May 27th.
And now to Brandon for sports.
Thanks, Miguel. You may recall the very first newscast this school year featured Christine Carpenter winning the gold overseas as the USA water polo goalie. It is fitting then that we end where we began. Congratulations go out to Christine Carpenter for winning the Ken Hubbs Award for the top athlete in the area. Christine beat out the athletes from all their surrounding communities to accomplish this feat. Congratulations, and we'll see you in the Olympics.
Graduation is nearly upon us. Speaking of graduation, here is the part four of our four-part series on the seniors of 2023. Shoutouts.
I'll shout out my parents, my girlfriend Sydney, Cyanide, get the money over there. Got Mr. Jeffrey, pitcher.
I'd like to shout out my boy, my Jacob Cotton boy. Come here, Cotton boy. Always hooks me up with clothes. I'd like to shout out my boy Collins. Oh yeah. And my boy Eric behind the camera, yurt. And shout out just all the homies.
I want to shout out my mom, my dad, and definitely Ryan Reynolds. I love that guy.
I'd like to make a shout out to my dad, my aunt, and my cousin Raya, and my boyfriend Travis, and without them, I wouldn't be able to graduate.
Myself, I did this all on my own.
All right, keep in mind, seniors, that it's not too late to be a part of this video. The full version will be shown on the Jumbotron for your guests at graduation, so be sure to seek out a Thunderstruck staff member or report to room A7 if you haven't been approached elsewhere to be on this video. You may answer all four questions or just those of your choice.
In art news, the winners are in from this year's YHS Film Festival.
The best short film was The Dream by Riley Quinalty, which was a lucid nightmare.
And the best competition film was Freebird by Eric Ortega, which was a prison break movie.
Congratulations, and thanks to everyone who came out to watch the show.
Which, by the way, was 95 people.
Just saying.
So I'll tape it.
If you have at least tuned in maybe a few times throughout all of high school, I'm sure you've recognized at least one of our faces. I'm Michael.
I'm Sarah.
I'm Samuel.
I am very grateful for being at Thunderstruck for 3 years straight. About half of my entire schooling, I've been in a video production class, and I've always wanted to be in a high school newscast, so I'm very thankful to be here. I'm also very thankful for the students that actually watch this, and more importantly, the teachers that play that. Just know, teachers, that you really make the Thunderstruck staff happy knowing that you play it.
I've been in Mr. Pitcher's video production class since my freshman year. I've always just enjoyed hanging out with the people in the class and being able to learn different editing techniques, filming techniques, doing anchor, and all that other fun stuff. But I've also done the animations that you see in the little beginning of some episodes. I also just miss the fun memories that we've had here, and I'm very grateful I took this class.
Yeah, it's honestly unbelievable that it's all coming to a close. You know, we're all gonna do our own thing. It's great. We had a lot of fun. Big shout out to Jeff Pitcher. He really put this whole thing together. Executive producer, director, mentor, coach, friend, all this creativity. It's been great. I really had a lot of fun with it.
Well, that'll do it, everyone. This school year has flown by.
Best of luck, class of 23, but don't forget to watch Thunderstruck on YouTube in the future while you're embarking into the next phase of your lives.
And as for the rest of you, we'll catch you next year.